This is where the social distancing part gets a little funky.
Look at Riz.
Give him some hand sanitizer. I love it.
Other times, just random chance. Ramirez in the air, right field. Garcia, nope, Robert, what? Whoa, I mean, we told you he'd play straightaway right. He just comes into the picture.
Well, he's taller, and that's what Leary is saying. He goes, look, you got all that area out there.
What happened? I have no idea. They're looking at the mound.
Oh, okay. Whew. Man, don't do that to me.
Yeah, me. I was a little worried, too. So something is going on with the mound that Zach's not happy with. Well, Zach Greinke, after allowing that last hit, obviously went to the home plate umpire, Corey Blazer, and said something. And so he walked into the dugout with Martin Maldonado and called out the Padres grounds crew to kind of clean up that landing spot. Now they're checking with Zach to see if it's to his liking here.
Yeah, Zach went out there and said, hey, guys, I've got phenomenal numbers in this Petco Park.
Yeah.
Something is wrong with the mound.
Day at the beach for Zach.
Yeah, he's just, hey, what, you guys working?
I'll just be here. You guys let me know when you're done.
He is some kind of nice.
All right, Zach's like, my rest is over. Thank you, guys. It looks like a brand new mound.
You did a good job pretty quick there.
Yeah.
More light moment. We just saw it. A very light moment, a very funny moment. McCutchen finding a fan, giving him a baseball after the ball landed freely in foul territory. And this one, after he ran it down, he's looking for a youngster. Hey, found one. There you go, young fella. Nice.
Guess he cheered the loudest.
And that is strikeout number 13 for Trevor Bauer.
I mean, is there any way to be ready for that pitch after seeing pitches 78, 82, and then he goes 96 with looks like rise on the outer part of the strike zone? Look at goofing around right there. David Bell's coming out to take him out of the game.
Oh.
And he took a little crow hop like he was going to throw the ball over the center field wall,
which he did last year. He may not be taking him out.
No, he is. I got a question, though. If Bauer were to throw the ball and hits a tundra sign, I'll let you go home and think about that one. What an effort by the Red starter today.
I mean, he's a machine.
Yep.
Athletically.
Plus, I love the fact that he truly believes that every ball that goes in the air is his. Then maybe he gives you a chance to catch one every now and then, but it is his until you catch it.
Now look, that's ridiculous timing. Come on, stop it. No, don't be doing that. Pick and roll, Eloy Jimenez.
He looks at him going, wait a second, can I catch a ball every now and then? This is hit to Eloy. I mean, it's his ball. Well, it was his ball. It's not going to be his ball because it's Luis's ball.
When he gave him the look, like, uh-uh.
Big smile on Luis's face. And Eloy just stands there going, you did that again. Why do you do that?
Does Maldonado have a Father's Day clip-on tie today? Is that allowed?
That's what it is. That's amazing. I've never seen that before. That's outstanding.
And with it being light blue, he's hoping that it blends in with his chest protector.
That's really clever. I wonder if it'll stay on with a foul tip. You know, of course, we hope he didn't get hit by one of those. But that's what all that protection's for.
Yeah, the throw to Lindor was.
Oh, it was just awkward.
Yeah.
Here it is.
You know, that's child's play there.
Well, here's some child's play for you. Get away.
Hunter Pence signing autographs. Not surprised.
I think we saw he had a Perry's look like a mimosa or a screwdriver.
But that's what you're supposed to look like when you're retired.
Yeah. Although, you know, I bet you could check back in with Hunter Pence in about 10 years and he'll still look like he could play some right field.
In the air left center. Eloy Jimenez against the sun and against Robert. And Luis parks himself right out in front for out number two.
Well, I think he saw that Eloy had some trouble looking straight up in the sun. It's a lot easier if you're coming across.
This is well hit to right, but playable. Irvin in, and he makes the running catch coming toward the line. And that's it. Reds win it. Final score, 5-0. The Reds shutting out the Royals in game two of this doubleheader.
My command was there most of the game. There's a couple of bats where I lost it, but I was happy about that. And I think my fastball played well today. Cutter was good. Slider was good. Things were kind of hit and miss. I missed with some pitches more than I usually did, but found a way to get through me. Like, if I can get to two strikes quickly, like, I do very, very well in 0-2, 1-2 counts. The more of those I can have, the better off I'm going to be.
Well, we've had trouble all road trip with this camera, and I'm just really thrilled. And this camera is so slick.
No!
Everything I touch. How did that happen? Kurt, it's not coming out of my paycheck. You got insurance on this thing. I'm sorry.
First your knee and now the camera. This has been.
This is what happens when you have 8-1 games. Sorry. Are you all right? Poor baby.
That was ball four and Reynolds is on with a 2-out walk. That's the best thing that's happened all year.
You think? Silly.
So Ozzie, with all of that age experience over Ronald Acuna Jr., has just hit a home run.
He's retired each of the first four that he's faced. What in the world do we have here? Ozzie Albies and Ronald Acuna Jr. Nap time. Getting a little massage there. A little scalp massage. Best of friends, those two.
They're probably going, listen, I think I'm a little stressed right now. I need to find a way to relax. Come over here. I got you.
I got you. I got just the thing.
He would like himself to do, but he's taking his walks.
Checked his swing and took a strike. That's the second time Donaldson's taken issue with Dan Bellino.
You can see him say, I'm asking, was it on the swing or was it on the pitch? But if he says you swung, then you go, okay, fine, yeah, I swung, whatever. You're not going to argue that, but if you think that ball that was 5 inches off the plate.
And now here comes Rocco Baldelli.
See, we didn't see this at the beginning of July in this series. But you can tell the intensity of these games is really starting to ramp up. And, you know, Rocco protecting Donaldson, number one, from getting thrown out of this game, arguing with the home plate umpire, but at the same time, trying to figure out why he's arguing with his hitter in the middle of an at-bat.
And then this, deep down the left field line, home run. Donaldson with a solo home run. And the Twins have hit three against Lopez this afternoon.
And what a move by manager Rocco Baldelli to come out and defuse that situation, let Donaldson focus back in on what he's trying to do. And then the spark that he needed, Donaldson didn't miss it.
He tossed him. They just tossed Donaldson for kicking dirt on home plate as he crossed home plate. So now here comes Rocco Baldelli, and he's likely to get tossed too. Donaldson kicked dirt on home plate as he crossed it, and Dan Bellino's just kicked him out of the game.
You see something you may maybe never have seen before. I have never seen a guy get thrown out after hitting a home run. But Donaldson obviously fired up. You don't like to see him getting ejected, but sometimes the emotion just gets the best of you.
Well, Bellino looking at him as he left the batter's box, almost as if he anticipated something happened.
I mean, I shouldn't be laughing, but I mean, I've never seen that before.
That's... And then Josh getting his money's worth.
Fastball there, challenged him upstairs, and down goes Garcia. Four straight strikeouts for Bauer.
Garcia's the guy. What is he? He's the make-believe guzzling a couple of 12 ounces out there.
Budweiser's.
Garcia is a perfect guy to throw the fastball on. His batting average on a fastball is the 12th worst in baseball.
Pop it open. Ah.
Oh, yeah.
And that's a new record. The stat we just showed you, now 46 strikeouts through first five starts. Gets away from Barnhart. He will tag. And how about Trevor Bauer? Eight innings of one-run baseball on the most crucial game of the season. That is a big-time performance.
At least 6 months. I wish we had three games.
11 strikeouts for Trevor Bauer. Jairis Familia allowed a ninth-inning run, and that was the difference. And that's 12 strikeouts for Trevor Bauer. It's going to be it. What a performance by Trevor Bauer today. It'll be up to the Cincinnati bullpen from here on out. Both starters brilliant in this series opener.